Hi everybody, this is Mika Vantu, and in this video I'm going to show you how I replaced the very professional door holding solution with a very cool and modern door lock. So let's follow me along. If you have seen my channel update video where I've been talking about my new room which I'm in right now, you also know that the door was just held with a piece of wire and this was not a very professional solution, and the rain came in like 2 times because of thunderstorms from the south. Well, it was not good, and finally I'm here replacing it. Also in the last video, I've promised that I will upload more frequently, but as you can see, it's already been more than 2 weeks again. But here I am with some new content. If you followed me on Twitter, you would know that my first door lock attempt was a complete fail, as the outdoor terminal melted. Why did it melt? Because it was printed in cheap PLA. And we all know that PLA has a very low melting point, and it gets already soft at about 55 degrees Celsius. And well, in the summer heat, with about 85 degrees Fahrenheit out, and the sun burning directly onto the new door lock terminal, it started to bend. And this was not good at all, specifically after the next thunderstorm came and the whole water came inside. Well, the solution to the outdoor terminal is reprinting it in PETG. What do you need for a door lock like this? It's not a lot. You need an Arduino Uno, which is the head of the whole operations. You also need some relays, and I went with 2, as I wanted to switch the indicators, you know, the red and the green lamp outside, that they are switched independently from the door lock, so that nobody just screws it out and attaches 12 volts to the green indicator to open the door. That's not possible with 2 relays. I also added a 1 amps fuse to the whole assembly, as I have 12 volts coming from an enclosure, not this one, but another one, which is fused to 10 amps, and I wanted to use some thin wires, so 1 amp is completely sufficient for both the door lock and the Arduino. Well, speaking of the door lock, you obviously need one. Mine works with both 12 volt AC and DC, and draws like a few milliamps. It's not a lot, and it works completely fine with a 1 amp fuse. For the outside terminal, you need an LCD, and the one I used is a small 16 characters 2 lines LCD. You also need some keypad. I went with a 3x4 button keypad, and they are very cheap as well and self-adhesive. But I'm not sure whether they are waterproof. Probably not. You also need some wires, and also you are going to need some pin heads and pin head sockets. Here you can see the whole schematics for the assembly. Basically, if you just wire it according to the schematics, everything is fine. I'm operating the LCD via the I2C bus, which saves me a lot of wires because I need to pull them through the wall from the inside enclosure to the outside terminal, and I didn't want to draw like 6 wires or what you need otherwise. If you follow my schematics, everything should work fine. I suggest starting off with the 5 volt assemblies like the Arduino and the relays or the connection to the relays, the LCD and the keypad. Also make sure that you can plug the wires out and in, so don't do something for the eternity, because you need to disassemble it later on when you want to get it through the wall. Then make sure to test it out. Connect the Arduino to the USB slot of your PC, upload the firmware, which I will show you how to do in a minute, and then try it out. Once you have assembled the 5 volt part successfully, move over to the 12 volt parts. The 12 volt part includes the power source for the Arduino. Then also make sure that you connect the relays properly. I just wired the door lock using 0.75 square millimeter wires or 1.5 square millimeter wires. But considering that I have fused it to 1 amp, 0.25 square millimeter wire would do just as fine. Once you have finished the hardware setup, now it's time to move over to the software part. Well, actually, you need to do the software part before the hardware part, or at least you need to install the firmware onto the Arduino Uno to get it running at all. Well, the software installation is a little bit more complex. The installation on the PC consists of 3 main steps. The first step is to download and install the Arduino IDE. Just click here on software, the link is down in the description by the way, and hit downloads. On the downloads page, just get the latest version, in this case it's 1.8.5, and just click the Windows installer.
Once it's finished downloading, just execute the installer. Here in the setup, we are just going to install it normally. You can just install it to the default location, but I'm actually going to install it to a different one, but this doesn't matter. Then hit install, and this takes some time. Well, if you're installing it for the first time, it might pop up some install driver windows, just accept all of them. As you can see, it's finishing up. Just hit close and launch the quick launch icon. There we go. Seems like we have successfully installed the IDE. Now it's time to install the library we need. Just follow the second link in the description. It's the liquidcrystal_i2c library, because we are going to operate the LCD screen via the i2c bus. Be aware that there are multiple liquidcrystal_i2c libraries around, and this is the only one that works with my example, so make sure to download that and not the other ones. Just hit clone or download, download the zip file. We'll also install it onto the desktop. Now let's extract it. We've now extracted it. Now we are just going to open the documents folder. As far as I know, if you install the Arduino IDE, these folders are generated, but I'm not sure. If you don't have them, just create them. And into the libraries folder, we are going to create a new folder with the name of the library, basically liquidcrystal_i2c. I'm not sure whether you have to take care of the capitalization, but I would actually, like this. Open it, open the master here, and just copy all the contents over to this newly created library folder. Alright, the third step is to download my software, the actual door lock logic. There is a reason why it's on Basepin and not on GitLab or GitHub, and that's because the code is terrible. I'm not a C or a C++ programmer by any means, but a C# programmer, and therefore I don't know a lot about this language. Well, probably there are a thousand ways to make this code more efficient, but it works at least. Once you arrived on this page, just click here on download, then select all files, change the extension to .ino, then I just create a new folder here and call it doorlock. I've just created it in the desktop because it's good enough. Open it up. And now make sure that the file is called the same as the folder. That's important. In my case, doorlock.ino. Then save. Then go to the desktop, open the doorlock folder, and open the doorlock.ino file. Once the file opened, hit verify to check for errors from my side, and then scroll down all the way to the bottom, or nearly all the way to the bottom, so that you arrive at the configuration area here. You can configure almost everything in my software, but if you are going to use a similar or same setup as I did, the only thing that you should change is the passphrase. And let's change it to 123456 0. Hit verify again to check for any errors. And as you can see, luckily there are none. And then go into tools, select the correct board. In my case, it's an Arduino Uno, but it will work on other ones as well. Also select the correct board. Currently, I don't have the Arduino connected to the PC as it's already installed, but if you're not sure what board is the correct one, just search for Device Manager in your Windows search, go to Boards, and normally your Arduino should be listed here. And if everything is fine, just hit Upload. And there you go. That's how you install my software on your Arduino Uno. Now that your setup is working on the table, now it's time to install it. For the installation, you need to print some parts, namely the inner enclosure, which consists of two parts, the outer enclosure, which consists of two parts as well, and I will include a dual color version for single extruder machines as well. I have already made a video about the special color change command you need to add into your Gcode file, and you can check it out over there. You also need a way to fix the Arduino and the relays into the enclosure. And I just went with a DIN rail, so there are also a lot of adapters available. I will link them all down below, so make sure to check them out. And now let's test it out.
And that's it for this video. Make sure to check out all the resources down below. And if you have any questions or any problems, make sure to leave them down below as well. Have a nice day. See ya.